11 News reporter Sheldon Dutez has been following the case. He joins us live from Pikesville and has the very latest. Sheldon?
Well, Rod, the cause of this carbon monoxide leak is still unknown. County officials say it's the property owner's responsibility to get a hired professional in here to see what the cause of that may have been. I'm going to move out of the way real quick. Investigators have been coming in and out of the home for the past 5 minutes now. We're not sure if that is part of their investigation and so forth into what happened. In the meantime, until we find out what happened, no one will be staying in this home on Colby Road. Health officials posted this bright orange sign to let people know this home on Colby Road is still not safe.
I believe they have issued a correction notice that the home cannot be reoccupied until a licensed master gas fitter or a plumber comes back to take a look at what's going on there.
A huge carbon monoxide leak in the home killed two people Sunday morning. 11 others were rushed to the hospital, including two children and three police officers.
It was shocking. It was surprising to me. It was breathtaking.
Officials haven't released the victims' names, but a close family friend has identified them as Nelvin Salguero and Inayel Lemus.
They were great people, you know, people that didn't do really bad things, you know, worked hard, tried to send money to their family, tried to do everything possible.
Friends say the men are from Guatemala and were staying with co-workers at the home. According to state records, the owner of the home is Santos Martinez. He was home Sunday morning and treated for carbon monoxide poisoning. There were no working carbon monoxide detectors in the home. Officials are checking to see if Martinez rented the property against county code.
The number one lesson that we can learn from this tragedy is that every single residence, whether it's a home, a townhouse, or an apartment, should be equipped with carbon monoxide alarms.